As a voice teacher, one of my greatest rewards is witnessing a student admit and discover and move through habits that might have censored their ability to communicate.
Donna Rosa, I wonder, just a quick run over with the iron.
Good, and a little more range in the Italian. Entrando per gli occhi.
Entrando per gli occhi.
Good.
Donna Rosa, I wonder, just a quick run over with the iron.
Yes, good, going up.
And to take those habits and shift them into something more positive so that they're more able to express themselves, no matter whether it's with just one person or with a scene partner, with the audience, so that they're able to really bring all of themselves to their work.
Ah!
Entrando per gli occhi mi fe sospirare.
And actually, can you do what you just did?
Ah!
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 Some people need to be coaxed, some people need to be joked with, some people need to look at it from a visual point of view, some people need time to allow themselves to feel that the shift's happening inside. And so that's a challenge to find the way in. But it's also one of the greatest parts of this work, because I really enjoy getting to know people, getting to find out how I can help them and guide them. In the very first year of training, they are required to write two self-created pieces. One is an I Am From template piece, where they have to describe their different sayings in their family, the different codes that might speak as a peer group, all of that kind of thing. And then they do a contemporary monologue. And then in the second term, they work on Shakespeare and they do Shakespeare sonnets, a classical sonnet in that structure, using their own experiences. And it's very using contemporary language. And then in second year, they do a public speech, and it can be anything to really rant about something, to find a speech that they're passionate about. And then in their third year, they do a virtuosic piece. They take a piece that's huge, whether it's Beckett, whether it's Greek, and they get a real chance to use their full range and power of their voices, as well as their acting ranges as well. And I think that there's a huge amount of discipline that's learned here. If you don't have the discipline to get into a practice room and work on your breathing or work on your connection to text, you can worry all you like, but you're not going to help yourself that way, because without an open and available body, you can't have an open and available voice.